Can you have that lady here? Lady stranded.
Lady hot, hot.
A moxie. Broken. A Chevrolet bus metals. Broken. What? Patty. Oh, Patty. But. Okay. Everybody's done. Thanks.
What did they say? Will someone come?
No chance. The mechanic's having a baby in this room, doctor.
A baby? What am I supposed to do about my car? How am I supposed to get back to Argos?
I've offered you a ride on my bike.
And I told you I couldn't possibly ride on that thing.
Why not?
I am 36 years old.
Maybe you could try some insides out. Well, look, I know what you need. Wait a minute. I'll be right back. Now, as soon as you're done with that Kleenex commercial, this should help.
You do make yourself at home.
I come to this little joint all the time. I've been camped down on the beach for a couple of weeks now.
Doing what?
Painting.
Are you an artist?
No.
A student?
No.
What are you then?
What do you think I am?
I think you're a nutty kid bumming around on a motorcycle.
That's what I am. A nutty kid bumming around on a motorcycle.
What's this?
Ouzo. Try it.
Sacred to Aphrodite.
It is.
And that bay down there, Ithia?
That's where Paris first made love to Helen after he carried her off.
Troy, Helen?
And I think they're supposed to have spent a night over there, too. It's the same legend all over Greece. Hey, before we go swimming, what's your name?
I'm Helen.
I'm Peter Lathan.
Peter Lathan.
And what I'm offering here is a cool dip in the blue achieve, a gourmet meal, a civilized conversation in English. You'll forget all your troubles.
Will I?
It's a promise. Come on.
Should I?
Sure.
Really?
Yes, I really think you should.
Should we bring a bottle?
Great. Come on.
Oh, dear.
What's the matter?
I was just wondering how Helen of Troy managed about her mother.
There, Marky.
The actor's back.
The actor's back. Can I see Ann?
She's busy now. You'll have to wait. You know, she just got back from Greece.
How was Greece? Did she have a good time?
Well, she went with her mother.
You have answered my question.
Sure, she's a big fan of yours.
to divorce apartments. Oh, they're always the best.
Watch the columns, Mrs. Adams. She's a looker. Been looking through us for 10 years. Have to see you later, Billy.
Wait a minute. How was Greece?
It was covered with myrtle.
Myrtle? Hey, Mark. That trip seems to have done her good. What's she up to? Is she happy?
In her opinion, she's happy. In my opinion, she should have a husband.
She's had two husbands.
Are we counting you?
Certainly we're counting me. She got a customer in there?
A rich one. Owns a whole string of hotels.
Great. How is business, generally?
You can't be broke again.
There's no such word as can't.
But you had 3 shows in the last month. I read where you go from New York to L.A., L.A. to New York.
I stop off in between.
Las Vegas.
Where else? New York? Margie, I'm a lonely, ruthless man.
Margie, can you get me the keys for 880 if you got him hungry?
Maybe.
And you're looking absolutely gorgeous. I've never seen you so goddamn radiant.
You can't be broke again.
I'm a lonely, ruthless man. Just for the first, Annie.
There you go. Thanks, Marty. If I put this one over, I'll help you out. How much do you need?
I can use 1,000, but I'll take 500.
Thanks. I need the money.
Bye, Marty.
Bye. Oh, Mr. Boylan, you're a lonely, ruthless son of a bitch.
Oh, Margie. That's what my mother used to call me.
Mrs. Margo, Mr. Edwards has decided he's quite interested in 880. I'm going to take him over for a look.
You wait right here while you whistle up that driver. He had to park around the block. We'll be out in front in 3 minutes.
Oh, Lord, 880. I promised the Bigelows we'd hold off for at least another week on 880 until they know whether their daughter is...
You got another buy for the place? Look, Mrs. Staley, you show me the lab, and if I like it, you've got my check this afternoon.
I'll take it, and I'll take care of the Bigelows.
Well, thanks, Mrs. Boswell. I like your style. You and I are going to get on just fine. What do you drink?
Diet Pepsi.
You'll get a case.
A whole case.
I'm glad you reminded me about the Bigelows.
What Bigelows?
You made them up.
I lead a rich fantasy life.
What's wrong?
Why don't you ever wear those cute red pumps?
I hate them. They hurt.
He's a bachelor. Limp a little.
Mr. Edwards?
He's rich. He makes quick decisions. Limp a little.
Margie, will you get it through your head that I'm no longer a Venus flytrap? I am 38 years old, going on 39.
I didn't hear it. I refuse to hear it.
You heard it for the 1,000th time. I am a middle-aged woman with a 17-year-old daughter.
Stanley Realty.
See you tomorrow, Margie.
Could you hold a minute, please? You called 38, middle-aged.
Sure.
Well, I've never been so insulted in my life.
Give up, Margie. We've all got to go sometime.
Sorry to keep you waiting. Yes, we handle suburban rentals. Could you give me some idea of the price you're having on? About $150 a month? Where? In Greenwich? Well, I really don't think you're going to find anything in Greenwich for that price. Now look, dear, would you be willing to go a little further out of town? Well, like Cleveland?
I didn't realize I had them on.
last night? Around 5. 5 a.m.?
5 a.m.
You haven't even the decency to lie. Who are you out with till 5 a.m.?
Mark and Rudy and Bert.
Mark who? Rudy who? Bert who?
Who goes formal? They're just kids that go dancing with or shoot a little pool.
Shoot a little pool? How feminine.
That's Arthur for me.
Arthur? You've never mentioned an Arthur. Arthur who?
I'll ask him when he comes in.
Hello, are you Trina Stanley?
Who are you?
He's Arthur.
Peter.
Arthur Peter, okay.
Didn't Arthur call? Oh, well, since he's around the block for my date, I'm over here by you. We exchange. I mean, I'm picking you up for Arthur. He's bringing my date.
Okay. Trina, if you don't mind, I'd like to meet Arthur.
This isn't Arthur, this is Peter, my grandmother, Mrs. Hayes.
How do you do? And where are you delivering my granddaughter this evening?
Nice, Grandma.
But I wish to know where Peter is taking you, Trina.
We're meeting Arthur and the others at the Electric Circus.
Then on to some cool emporium, I presume.
You'll pay for this, Granny.
But I simply want to know where...
Tell you what, take off my tights right now.
Trina, you are not leaving this house with a boy whose last name you don't even know.
My vitamin's all gone. Who's been messing
around? Granny did it. And this young man, whom Trina has never met, nor I gather even heard of, rings the doorbell as a proxy for Arthur.
He's had the decency to pick me up as a favor to Arthur.
Arthur who?
How should I know? He's a friend of Peter.
Peter who?
Peter Latham.
Peter Latham.
Peter Latham. All right. Latham. I went to school with a Latham girl from Pittsburgh. Isabella Latham.
Now she's my own.
No. Well, isn't that extraordinary? But if Isabella is your aunt, then you're a Hohenhauser.
My mother was a Hohenhauser.
What a teeny weeny world!
Well, Anne,
this is Peter Latham. This is Trina's mother, Mrs. Stanley.
How do you do?
How do you do, Mrs. Stanley?
Trina, please ask Mr. Latham to sit down.
No, Mother, he doesn't want to sit down. Can't you see they want to go along? Have a nice evening, Trina. Good night,
Peter.
Good night, Peter.
Good night, children. Have fun.
Good evening, Mrs. Stanley.
Good night, Mommy. Good night, Granny Maude. You really are something else. Come on.
A Hohenhauser! And a Hohenhauser!
Tell me about the Hohenhausers. They're in steel, aren't they?
And, dear, the Hohenhausers are in money.
And the Lathams?
Well, Isabella Latham had, I think it was two brothers. Was it three? Oh, well, that doesn't matter. What matters is that this one brother married the Hohenhauser girl, who must have inherited everything. This boy, this Peter, the son. Didn't you think he was absolutely charming? How old do you think he is? About 20?
22.
It's after 5. Why don't you go home? I'm just finishing up this lease. Stanley Realty? Yes? Who's calling? Oh, Mr. Edwards. Mrs. Stanley is right here. Just a minute. Hello, Eddie. I was just about to leave. Oh, well, dinner sounds fine. No, no, I'd really rather go home first and get myself pulled together. Oh, give me about an hour and a half. Fine. See you then. Oh, it's apartment 8B. B as in,
Bouillabaisse.
Bouillabaisse. Okay? Bye.
Well, you must have lived real good.
I'm living with Mr. Edwards.
take you home.
No, thank you. This is Mr. Latham. Mr. Latham is,
looking for a studio apartment.
Yes, that's right. I'll take care of him, Mrs. Margot, when you go along.
I see. Don't forget, you have an appointment later with Mr. Edwards.
I won't forget.
I see.
Penelope Schwartz. It's a pretty strong defense. Give the guy the wrong name and number, so when he doesn't call, it's because he couldn't, not because he didn't want to.
Did you really try to find Miss Schwartz? It never occurred to me that he would.
Why'd you cut out? The next morning he disappeared. He just cut out.
I'm sorry, but now you know why. I mean, among other things, I am the mother of a grown daughter.
Let's have dinner. Button on my lapel, Stanley Realty sleeps around.
Now, please listen to me. This entire situation is just horribly embarrassing.
Let's have dinner.
Peter, I can't be seen running around with just a kid. I could be arrested.
Risk it.
You've got to understand my position.
I do. I understand your position.
Then you must realize why I can't see you again. I'm sorry, but that's just the way it is.
I see.
I'm really sorry.
I'm sorry, too.
Thank you, Peter. You're very understanding. Goodbye, Peter.
It's a cloud burst. I was on my way. Why, Peter Latham, how nice to see you.
Hello, Mrs. Hayes. It's a very dashing raincoat.
I'm so glad you like it. It's Trina's.
Looking for an apartment.
Yes.
I thought perhaps Mrs. Stanley could help me.
Unfortunately, I haven't a thing to offer him.
But how nice of you to come to Anne.
Natural selection.
That's sweet. Well, I've been to the hairdresser. Rain, wouldn't you know? Naturally, not a taxi in sight. I guess we'll just have to sit it out.
Mother, I can't wait. I have a date, and I have to change. So let's just make a dash for the subway.
The subway?
I have my car here.
Aren't you marvelous?
Absolutely marvelous. But I don't want to take you out of your way.
No, I'm sure, Mr. Latham.
Peter.
Wouldn't mind dropping us off, especially if we invite him up for tea.
Oh, I'd love to.
Oh, yes, you have a date. Well, Trina and I will just have to look after Peter. She'll be delighted to see you.
I'm sure she will. I owe her $17. She hustled me in a pool room. Well, my car's right out front, the little red Maserati.
A Maserati? Oh, what? Dolce Vita!
Come on, let's go.
Peter, I do not want you to come up to my apartment.
I promised your mother.
Peter, this is ridiculous.
Left arm. That's a girl.
You cannot behave like this.
Have you really got a date tonight?
Yes, I do.
Well, who have you got a date with?
Please, I can button my own coat.
Well, who have you got a date with?
Now, Peter, we're going out. You're going to drive Exactly. Well, I must make a phone call. I'm sure you young people can get along without me for a few moments. You two must have a lot to talk about. You owe me.
$17. I have it ready.
Poor concentration. That's your trouble.
Pretty wet out there today.
Yeah, all day.
I don't mind rain.
Rain's okay.
So, what's new since the other night? $6:45.
Don't be nervous. I am not at all nervous. You know how to grab it.
day.
Mother, may I present Mr. Edwards, my mother, Mrs. Hayes.
My daughter has talked so much about you, Mr. Edwards.
Is that a fact?
And this is my daughter, Tina. How do you do, Mr. Edwards?
Hello, young lady. Looks seem to run in the family. And this is your son. Hi, young fellow.
Peter is a friend of my granddaughter's, Mr. Edwards.
Natural mistake. He's handsome enough to be yours.
Thanks.
It's chicken.
Bourbon, rocks, no water. It's great to be around the family together like this. My wife died a year ago.
I'm so sorry, I didn't know. My daughter tells me you've just acquired a marvelous new apartment.
And very expensive. I hear Mommy clipped you.
That's right, kid, and I love it. A dainty little father and this pretty little lady looks you straight in the eye and says, 150, and you know she means big ones.
That's high class clipping.
Say, I hope you'll throw in some free advice. You could give me a couple of hints about drapes and chins and all that shit.
I have never heard the decorating business more accurately described.
Has the rain let up, Mr. Edwards?
Yeah.
You'll stay, Peter. You can join us for a petite dîner.
Well...
It's okay, Pete. You can stay if you want.
Thanks, I'd like to.
And later we can shoot some pool at McGurk's.
Little girl like you shooting pool? She just looks like a little girl. She's really Paul Newman.
I'm ready.
Then I guess we're off, but I sure hate to leave all these nice people.
Well, I don't.
Good night, Mother. Trina, goodbye,
dear. Oh, I'll probably be here when you get back.
Trina, please take your feet off the table.
You too.
Mrs. Hayes, it's been good talking to you. Good night, young lady. So long, son. Sir?
I was just about to ring.
Oh.
It's not too late.
It's about 8 years.
You invited me to dinner.
I said, call me Wednesday, and if it's convenient, we can have dinner together.
This is outrageous. I brought Boo Goo Guy Pan. You love Boo Goo Guy Pan.
Oh, Mrs. Staley, if you really had a date with your beau.
He's not my beau, and I did not have a date with him. He's just a part-time ex-husband.
Oh. Billy Boylan? I've seen you on Man Place! It's Billy Boylan!
Eddie.
You're seriously gonna dump me tonight?
Now, if you're feeling abandoned, Billy, you can stay with us. We'll eat your moo-moo guy pan.
Listen, you know, it just seems like a shame to go off and leave a party.
Oh, please.
I got an idea. I'll get that driver to hurry over to the caviar tree. Caviar, smoked turkey, and salmon.
Be sure it's fresh caviar.
Sure.
Wine. We'll need wine.
Right, and then we'll have a real party right here. Okay? Okay?
Marvin.
Lovely. Well.
I'll be right back. Oh, my God, Billy Boy.
God, what a darling guy. Hey there, great boy. We'll do the table.
Salmon and caviar. I'll get the plates.
I'm going to change.
You're?
Peter Lane.
Trina's friend.
Hello, Peter. Billy Boy.
Billy Boy.
Well, let's get this show on the road. Glad to have you aboard, Pete.
Thanks. Well, how about you, Anna?
What about me?
Are you glad to have me aboard?
What?
Are you glad to have me aboard? Answer me.
What was the question?
Hey, Bill, tell me.
caviar.
I finished it this morning.
I noticed. What Anne really meant was, come on over and finish the dishes.
Bye. The dishes are done. Where are you off to?
To the flicks with some kids.
Bye, Billy. You were absolutely dazzling last night. The competition from Eddie must have stimulated you.
Rita, such a little bitch. I can't believe she's not my own daughter.
Well, Billy, you were pretty dazzling last night. Boy, were you dazzling.
My God, what a scene. Dancing the night away, me with Granny Maude.
Nobody forced you.
Eddie forced me. I didn't want to go on the town. Eddie forced me. He insisted he wanted me. Billy boy, Mrs. Hayes, little lady, funny, we're going on the town. Not on Big Ed. He wanted us.
He wanted to be polite. He wanted to make a good impression on me. That's what he wanted. But you and Mother...
Why pick on Maude and me? Treating young Peter certainly stayed the course. He's quite an attractive boy, isn't he?
No.
No? I thought he was quite attractive. Very poised.
He's not attractive to me.
I thought he was very attractive. Very poised.
He's too poised.
Does he treat his new thing?
What else?
I don't know. I thought maybe as Mama gets older, she fancies him younger.
What a filthy little showbiz.
Hey, hey, I'm sorry.
You can be the most tasteless...
Sorry.
There's nothing more revolting in this world than a creaky old lady running after a boy.
Come on now. You're only 38.
40.
What?
40.
40. You mean you're older than me?
You're 41.
38. It's in the celebrity register. 38. 3. 8. 42.
42.
Forget it. Anyway, I like that Eddie. He suits me fine. I like him.
I'm glad. If I ever run into him again, I'll tell him.
No kidding, kidder baby. You're seeing him tonight, I heard.
What's it to you?
It's about time you found someone to take care of you. Someone substantial like Eddie. I wouldn't want you screwing around with some little penny-ante adventurer.
Billy, I want you to know how much I truly appreciate. You're not minding your own business.
Stick with me, baby, and if the chance presents itself, maybe you can slip in a kind word to you, Billy.
I'll try to find one.
I'm not kidding. I need it.
You're not having trouble getting work, are you?
Not at all. I'm not pushing Richard Burton off the screen, but I think I'll probably survive him.
Then what?
Annie, the most extraordinary, the most unaccountable sensation has been zapping me this last year.
What is it?
It comes over me at the damnedest times. I'm on the set, the camera's grinding away, my nose down some stupid bird's bazoons. Suddenly, I hear this voice. Is this any way for a grown man to make a living? Or I'm horsing around with the gang in Vegas. Everybody's having a million laughs. Suddenly, I find myself wondering if I wouldn't rather be home with a book. I mean, a home with an upstairs, a wife, and a kid with remedial reading. At first, I thought I was losing my effing mind. And I've been putting on makeup for over 20 years, and now, suddenly, for no reason, it embarrasses me. I want to give up acting. Go straight.
You? Give up acting? You're too good.
True, but...
What on earth could you do?
I thought maybe Eddie. Annie, I want to try and get a job. I mean a real job.
Like what?
Public relations.
Public relations? Is that real?
I gotta start somewhere. What do you want me to do? Go cold turkey? I gotta have a drink.
No, you're going home.
Why?
Because I'm tireder than I thought. I want to get a little rest before Eddie gets here.
I accept that. Make yourself gorgeous. You know, go up?
He's been called to the coast on business. You surely don't want him to neglect your future. I'll go fix you something to eat.
Well, actually, Annie.
Are you going to walk out on me, too?
I've got a goddamn date.
Well, I should know better than to count on you for anything.
Honey, I've had this date all week.
So, who's the lucky girl?
Elkie.
Elkie.
You remember Elkie.
Elkie, who works upstairs? That big, blonde knockwurst?
That gorgeous, big, blonde knockwurst.
Billy, it's very disrespectful for you to sleep with the help in my building. This is a co-op. And since you're now so adult, you really ought to give up Mother's Helpers. I see her in the elevator all the time. She lets the kids' nose run. She's a minor. How old is she, anyway?
Almost 19.
Oh, that's right.
What is?
You are seducing an underaged kinder sitter. Why?
She don't bite back. Part of that growing up process I was describing to you is this marvelous goatish thing for helpless young girls. I guess it's maturity.
Oh, beat it, Billy. Everything's so utterly ridiculous.
I really am sorry about tonight. Apartment.
Peter, I want you to go now.
No, that's
that's not what you want.
I need it.
In all the hoo-ha around here, I think I forgot to mention that I am in love with you.
I'm very honored and terribly flattered. But Peter, for you to be in love with me, it just isn't convenient. Every time I move, I have to step over you. You can't just fling yourself into my life like some crazy cynic. You are upsetting things. My life has a certain balance and harmony.
We'd be better off with a little chaos.
Well, you certainly do provide that.
It's the youth bit. Spontaneity, say what you mean what you feel.
Action now.
You'll learn to love it.
No, I won't. Don't you see I've had all that power. Action now, isn't it? All I want is power. Tranquility now.
How about trying for death?
I mean it.
I don't believe you.
Then believe this. I am not attracted to young boys. Not you, not any.
Lady, that is a lie. I don't know about anybody else. You're certainly attracted to me. Why can't you admit it? What are you so frightened of?
It's horrible.
What is?
Falling all over a young man.
But you're not falling all over me.
Not yet.
Well, that was honest.
I am not in love with
you. You don't know whether you are or not. You're so spooked by the idea of what other people think, you can't think for yourself. Who are all those people whose opinions count so much? Your mother? Your daughter? Mayor Lindsay? Your mother's charming. She wouldn't care if I were still in short pants as long as she hooked up with the Hohenhausers.
Why do you marry him?
As for Trina.
Please go.
Look, Anne, you are a very beautiful, desirable woman. I love you, Anne. Let me love you.
Oh, God, it's my mother.
Well, good evening, Peter.
Good evening. I just dropped in.
Unfortunately, Trina isn't in.
Oh, but you'll wait for her, won't you?
You mustn't try to keep him, Mother. He's already said he had to leave.
Oh, what a pity. Well, Trina will be utterly shattered having missed you.
Yes.
Well, good evening, Mrs. Hayes. I'm glad I at least got a glimpse of you.
Come back soon. You're part of the family now. We've adopted you.
Charming.
It's super. He brings you home. What happens when he brings you home?
Nothing.
He doesn't kiss you.
Nope.
I don't believe it. My word. You don't suppose he's, you know?
No, he's not.
Well, how can you tell?
I asked him.
You asked him? Oh, you little idiot.
Granny, I think you ought to just settle down and accept the fact that Peter is not in love with me. You're never going to be related to the Hohenhausers. He doesn't dig me. I don't appeal to him.
But you're the living image of me.
Then you don't appeal to him. Nonsense.
He adores me. He's just shy. He needs encouragement.
Granny, I'm only 17. The world is full of eligible and attractive men. I'm not going to push the panic button because one of them doesn't drop dead at my feet.
Peter Latham can provide you with every luxury you can think of, and a great many more you've never heard of.
Saved by the bell.
Trina, please go to your room.
Why?
But that's Peter, and I want to talk to him. If you won't give the poor boy a little help,
I will.
If I were you, I wouldn't get mixed up in this.
Hello, Mrs. Hayes. I brought you some moron glacé.
You really do spoil us, Peter. But Trina's mother adores moron glacé.
Oh, does she? I just took a chance that somebody would. She, hasn't come home yet?
No, we're alone. We can play with our soul on us.
Great. Somebody's birthday?
Oh, no, that darling Eddie Edwards sent them.
Is he back again?
Just this morning. My, what a good-looking suit. Aren't you grand?
The old man was in town today. We had lunch.
He must be very proud of you. You take your position in the company very seriously. Basically, I feel you are a very serious person. You say you are?
About average, I guess.
Oh, no. Much more than average. I'm a very keen judge of character, Peter. Your emotions run very deep. Poor Peter. Well, I'm not a complete idiot, you know. I've seen through you for quite a while now. I know what's going on, Peter. Why you come here so often? And I know it isn't to play gin rummy with an old lady. Do you think I'm so old I no longer recognize love when it's right under my nose?
What are you getting at, Mrs. Hayes?
Just that I know you're in love, that I'm on your side.
You are?
And I'll do anything I can to help you. You have my promise.
Mrs. Hayes, I never dreamed you'd see it like that.
Of course, Trina is terribly young.
Who?
Trina. She's terribly young. I know, I know. She doesn't seem young. It's a very sophisticated generation. Not like when I was that age. Or even Anne. Anne was... I can see your cards. Anne was awesomely innocent. You know, sometimes I think she still is.
Yes.
Anne doesn't see things head on. What will be difficult for her to grasp is that age is not the question here. The question is simply what is best for the two individuals involved. You'll have to convince her that marriage is possible. Possible and desirable. You're knocking?
No, we're talking about marriage.
Of course. If you really love her.
Oh, but I do love her, Mrs. Hayes. It's just that marriage simply never occurred to me.
Peter, I'm shocked.
Well, there are obstacles, you know.
You're worried about your parents. That they'll think you're too young.
Well?
Can't you bring them around?
It would be interesting to try, but I'm not dependent on my parents.
It would be so much nicer if they did approve.
So much nicer.
Still, every couple must eventually live for themselves. Take a cup.
Do you believe that?
Yes. You must be very firm with Anne. She may fight you.
Don't worry. I'll handle Anne.
And Peter, dear, let
have 17 cards.
La, what a splendid suit. Playing drummer?
About the same as everybody else. So, when did the big wind from the west blow back in?
Ah, so that's what's eating you.
I just asked if you'd seen the big wind.
Would you mind fixing me a drink?
You're home late tonight.
There are a million rotten things at the office.
Why do you do it?
Why do I? I've got bad habits. I like to eat.
You could get married.
I've been married.
Not to me.
I can't marry you, Peter. It's against the teachings of my church.
The teachings of what church?
The over 30 Orthodox.
I'm not kidding, Ed. I'm asking you. Will you marry me?
I'm not kidding, Peter. I'm telling you no.
Why?
Because I know what would happen.
What would happen?
You know how old I am.
Oh, God. Look, suppose you were 35. Would you marry me if you were 35?
No.
30.
No.
29.
I don't think so. No, of course I wouldn't.
25. You know you will. So, okay, so let's suppose you're 25 and we get married. Then what happens?
How do I know?
Exactly.
How does anyone know what will happen in a marriage or in life?
Exactly. All anybody ever really has is now.
Here, please go. This is my night to, I really have to... polish the silver.
Okay, but while you're polishing the silver, will you think about it and try to think about nobody else but yourself?
I'll try.
Okay, go on, polish your silver.
Did I hear Peter leave? What did he say?
What did Peter say to you?
About what?
Well, I guess you know Brandon practically put a shotgun in him.
Mother, what on earth did you say to him?
I simply brought it to his attention that his feelings were perfectly obvious to me, and that I thoroughly approved, and I said I wanted to know his intentions.
Oh, you did.
He was surprised.
He was surprised.
But when I said I thought he should speak to you, he very quickly agreed. Well, what did he say? Did he declare himself?
He certainly did. Look, Mummy, I really don't...
Be quiet. I'm trying to talk to your mother about Peter.
It's not you he wants to marry, Granny. It's me.
Actually, what he's got in mind is something in between. Kind of compromise. Well, let's put it this way.
Do we want that casserole? Oh, Eddie, I didn't know you.
like I was saying, it may sound funny coming from a man who admits he wasn't much of a husband the first time out, but I swear to you, I could make a woman happy. The right woman.
Oh, I'm convinced.
I'd give her everything. She'd be a regular little queen. What I want above everything else is a family. My wife, my late wife, couldn't have children. And I don't think a man's lived his life unless he leaves children. And I'd like to have, hell, I'll take as many as I can get.
I see.
I'm only 45, and at 45 a man is at his peak. And I just know I'll make a good husband for Trina.
Trina?
Trina's gonna make some little mother that kid of yours.
Some little mother? Have you alerted Trina to this project?
We love each other, Anne. We want to get married right away. We don't see any point in waiting around.
Well, certainly not with you at your peak. How long has this been going on?
Well, to tell you the truth, you may not like this, but ever since that first night, the night we all went out together, it happened just like that.
Did you keep it secret? That wasn't very nice, Eddie.
I know that. It's been about to drive me crazy, but Trina was so sure you that
what?
Well, I've never been around girls Trina's age and been around them and their mothers, and I didn't know what to believe. But Trina was so sure you'd be jealous. Hell, Trina thinks just because she's interested in me, every other woman is too. She's such a kid.
Yes, she is. Too much of a kid for marriage.
Why? The way I see it, a woman of 18 and a man.
Trina's only 17.
She is? Why, that little devil. Well, the way I see it, a woman of 17, 18, and a man of 45 are a perfect balance.
Maybe in the Ozarks, Eddie. Not in this circle.
I love her, Anne.
Oh, for God's sake. If you're fool enough to let yourself fall in love with a 17.
If I'm a fool, then I'll just have to live with it.
Fine. But Trina will live with me.
You're going to find she was made up her own mind about where she's going to live.
Eddie, how would you like 10 to 20 in the state pen?
You've got a lot to think about, Anne. I'm going to run along now.
Now, wait a minute, Eddie.
And honey, you just bear in mind what good care I'll take of Trina. And of you, too.
Of me?
Naturally. I'm going to be your son-in-law.
Trina? Might as well tell you right now, honey, that if you pull something square, like trying to keep me from seeing Eddie, I'll just talk him into taking me to Tahiti or some other place out of your reach until I'm 18, and then we'll be married anyways.
You are playing Juliet to a fairly sedate Romeo.
I shouldn't think you'd want me to answer that kind, honey.
Trina, my big mistake is not sending you to a good, tough military school.
I'm going to marry Eddie.
Do you love him?
I think so.
You think so?
Well, he's crazy about me. He makes all the decisions. It's so easy to be with him. You thought Eddie was nice enough for you, didn't you?
I wasn't contemplating marrying Eddie.
You don't contemplate marrying anybody. You'd have let Eddie hang around just the way you let a kid like Peter just hang around. Only Eddie would have never asked you to marry him. You'd have brushed him off long before he got to the point. Because he is too trustful. He's a darling man. I decided I'd be damned if I'd let you waste him. So I swiped him.
So you swiped him?
Right from under your nose.
Well, that couldn't have been so hard, Trina. I mean, you are very young and very lovely. Any mother who thinks of competing with her daughter has lost before she starts.
Oh, I don't know. Peter?
Did you want Peter?
It wouldn't have mattered much if I had.
And if you had, then what?
Tough beans, that's what. Anyway, I don't want Peter. I want Eddie.
Why? Why Eddie?
I told you, he's great. He takes care of me.
Trina, I've taken care of you.
I'm sorry, Mommy, but you just don't make it as a father image.
Forget it, Mom. You've done okay. Oh, Trina, have I?
Well, you let me run all over you, of course, but you're so sweet that whenever you try to stand up to me, I make it a point to give in.
it's not too important.
Is he gone? Well, what was that all about? I obviously walked in the middle of something.
What he walked in the middle of was a proposal.
Eddie? Oh, Anne. Oh, my precious girl, I'm so happy for you.
Mother, it's not me Eddie wants to marry. Mother, it's Trina.
What? What in the world is wrong with everybody? Well, everyone's gone mad. Or is it me? Trina, my darling girl, I'm so happy for you.
Trina and Eddie?
They set date.
Little Trina and Big Ed. I can't believe it.
Well, at least he's still going to be in the family. I think I'll enjoy having a rich son-in-law.
Mr. Boylan.
I take a very European view of these things, Margie. Honest swap, qui m'allait pas.
Huh?
Never give a sucker an even break.
Here are the plans for the Gordonson place. Hi, Billy. Glad you're here.
I just heard the news from Walter Cronkite here. Is that what you wanted to see me about?
I just wanted to talk.
Well, I think I'll have an early lunch. I'll be about an hour and a half, if you don't mind.
It's all right.
I thought I might look for something to give the little bride. I may stop in at F.A.O. Sports.
Ask her out, buddy. Not Zom?
I am not at all Zom.
That's the spirit.
Oh, Billy, don't treat me as if I've been left waiting at the altar. The Big Eddie romance was all in your mind. And Mrs. Margolin's, and Maude's. I was never, ever interested in Eddie. I was just trying to help him out.
Well, now he's got Trina to help him out.
But who's going to help Trina?
Haven't you noticed yet that Trina helps herself? Look, this is the best thing that could have happened to Trina and to you. I think she was right on the edge of giving you a hard time. You would have loved it now.
Billy, he's 28 years older than she is. It's grotesque.
Why?
You don't think it is?
No. He's a very lively fellow. And Trina's quite mature in many ways. It's a perfectly natural attraction. Actually, Annie, you'd be surprised how devastating younger girls find me. There's something very sexy about this age.
Have you noticed that too?
Too?
What if I told you that I had a proposal?
You? No. Who?
Me. Yes. Peter Latham. Who?
Peter Latham. You mean that kid? Trina's little boyfriend?
He's not Trina's little boyfriend. He's my little boyfriend.
And he's asked you to marry him. What's he on? You gotta keep your eyes open with kids that age.
I'm so grateful. Solicitude, Billy dear, but I have known Peter for quite some time. He is not on drugs. He is extremely intelligent, holds down a responsible position in the family business. Hohenhauser Steel, that is.
Well, sure, but...
He's got money of his own, a mind of his own, and he wants to marry me. Rattled old, broken down, liver spotty me. He's even met you and Maude. And he still wants to marry
her. He must have a thing about his mother. Has he talked much about his mother?
He says she's very like Trina.
Annie, you don't mean you're taking this seriously. He's just a baby. A little bitty baby.
He's 22. Were you a baby at 22?
You're damn right I was. A little bitty baby.
Well, he isn't.
Are you serious? I can't believe it.
Believe it?
But Jesus, honey, have you thought?
What people would say.
Yes.
If you saw us and you didn't know us, if you saw Peter and me together in some public place, what would you think?
I think you're shelling out.
Do I look like the kind of woman who shells out?
No, of course you don't, Annie. I didn't mean that.
I don't think we look too utterly ridiculous together. I check mirrors constantly.
I mean, if we go anywhere.
People don't stare at us, really. I don't know if you are aware of it, but the latest statistics prove that a woman comes into her full sexual flowering at 40, while a man attains his at 20.
So you're in full flower, eh, kid? Give us a whip.
Damn it, I'm serious.
Okay. If the kid's to your taste, what the hell? Youth's great. Enjoy. We won't talk about it anymore.
You don't get it. It's not his youth that's to my taste bothers me terribly. But he's really a marvelous person. He's quite extraordinary. Very strong-minded. And he has a good deal of money. Once I stop to think about it, the overall picture, you understand, it suddenly seemed rather marvelous. I had stopped thinking about... Actually, I guess I kind of put myself out to pasture. And suddenly, here is this handsome, intelligent, rich young man who thinks that I am the greatest. Really, he loves me. He could have anybody he wants, and he wants me.
Well, wow.
Peter wants to marry me, take care of me. It's the damnedest thing. But after all these years, after two marriages, I finally find somebody strong. Sorry.
That's okay. Say it like it is.
I finally found somebody strong who really takes over. And he's a 22-year-old boy.
Anushka.
You're lovely.
Oh, for heaven's sakes, Billy, I'm 40 years old. It's quite enough to be loved. I have a few of my tomorrows taken care of.
I see. Yeah. It's to be a union of love on his part and fatigue on yours. Is that correct?
I don't want to talk about it anymore. Let's go have lunch.
You'll have to forgive me, darling. You seem to have lost my appetite. I'll call you tomorrow.
All right. Tomorrow. You're angry.
I'm not angry. I'm never angry.
Hello? Hello, is that you, Peter? Well, this is me. And I've called to say that after thinking it over carefully, weighing everything pro and con, I've decided that... Peter, don't interrupt me. Well, okay. The answer is yes.
But Anne...
I can't.
Anne...
You can't expect me to. Look at my hair. I do not want to meet them.
Why are you carrying on like this?
Because you've given me absolutely no warning. Look at my hair.
If I'd given you any more warning, you could have wriggled your way out of it.
Couldn't we please wait till after we get back?
Look, I wanted them to meet you before we got married. It's better this way. More spontaneous. When Mother called and said they were stopping off on their way to Paris, I thought, now, let's get it over with. So I told them.
Oh, God, what a scene that was.
I've told you 20 times what their reaction was. They were just surprised. Yeah. That's all, surprised.
Oh, Peter.
It had to happen sooner or later.
What's wrong with later? You could have stalled a while. They could have come to my funeral. I would have liked a little time to prepare myself for this interview.
It's not an interview. It's not like you're applying for a position as an upstairs maid.
They despise me.
How can they despise you? They haven't even met you.
Oh, Peter, I don't feel at all well. And look at my hair.
Stop it. You know perfectly well that absolutely nothing comes of this visit. We're getting married next week no matter what. If this meeting goes down moderately well, things will just be a hell of a lot easier, that's all. And if they don't like it, screw them.
Screw them.
I'll be interested to see how you react to the old man. He's something on wheels. Self-made, you know.
I thought he married, your mother is a poet.
That's not the way my father went about it. Grabbed the company away from my grandfather, kicked the old boy into a Scottish retirement, then took over the company, along with the daughter and everything else in sight.
My goodness, your poor grandfather.
Don't waste your sympathy there. My grandfather Hohenhauser was tough and mean and greedy. Bashed his way through a picket line once with a 7 on it. 6 notches on it. He used to show it to me. But still, my old man took him on and whipped him and set himself up there as King of the Hill before he was 35. Want to know something? He's next.
You're just a kid.
Shall I tell you why Dad will be willing to go along with my marrying you? Because he thinks you'll distract me. He knows his time is coming up. He feels me breathing down his neck, and he's not ready for the act.
Oh, Peter, that's...
Don't worry, I'm giving him 5 more years. He's 5 years from retirement. Relax, kid. Fix your hair. Well, there you are, Mother.
Darling.
Come in, Dad.
Darling, can you believe the coincidence? It's weird. Weird, weird, weird. Aunt Phyllis and I spent 2 winters in New York right after I came out. I took voice lessons from somebody right here in this very building. Right here in this very building.
Mother, I'd like you to meet Ann. Father, this is Ann, and this is my mom.
Mrs. Denley, I'm delighted to meet you. I'm so glad you were able to come.
You thought you insisted?
Yes, I know you did. Please sit down. Let me fix you something to drink.
Well, let me do it, Ann. I know what they're like.
What a charming apartment. Sweet. And you've decorated it so bravely.
Father!
come true. I'm cursed. Every time that I open my mouth, it's the situation. It will take some getting used to. But I'm going to call you Ben, of course. And I'm Christine. You know, I find myself liking you very much. Do you golf? I'm afraid not. Oh, well, we can always shop. Shop, shop, shop. My hunch is you'll make Peter very happy.
Do you really think so?
Why shouldn't you? Youth in a woman is frightfully overrated. Look at me. When I was young, I was homely, self-conscious, and shy, shy, shy. Actually, I was incapable of thinking of anyone or anything but myself. Mercifully, one grows up. One's responses to life at 40 are infinitely more tender. Tender, tender. Don't you see? You're at the very height of your whole sexual flowering. I like that. Shall I tell you what I really think? I think you're lucky. And I think Peter's lucky. Take me. Stuck with Edgar. Edgar. Oh, well. There's always golf, and one must simply organize one's life around the Edgars. A quarter to already, it's not possible. I must run.
Haven't been my mother-in-law for a long time. How treat you like a boot in the tail.
Starling at me isn't going to help Anne. Or me. Can you imagine how I feel, having that nasty little boy for a son-in-law? You should see him jumping around Anne, devouring her with his eyes. It's gruesome. The boy's not normal. Thank God he didn't get his hands on Trina.
How about Trina?
Well, Eddie's a perfect love. They're marvelous together. Trina leads him around by the nose. There, I guess you know who that is. If you don't mind, Billy, you can let him in.
Where do you think you're going?
To finish my packing. Trina and Eddie are taking me to the country. I shall spend Christmas as I should with my grandchildren.
Hello, young Peter.
Hello, old man.
Get back. Glad to see me.
And glad that you deserted us.
Never. I dashed back the minute my little job was finished. Well, how about offering me a drink?
All tuckered out?
Not particularly. Why?
Well, you seem to make yourself at home.
New management?
Scotch?
Please, with a splash of soda. What's that?
Can't seem to find the bottle opener.
There's an extra one that's kept in the black lacquer box on the left of the ice bucket.
Thanks, I'll make a note of it.
Good boy. You're a lucky guy.
Yes, I am.
That's scotch.
With a splash of soda, just the way you like it.
Oh, thanks. Here's the love. Anne going to give up the business?
We haven't really discussed it yet.
Now that she's got someone to take care of her. That is, really take care of her, if you know what I mean.
Yeah, I know what you mean.
I hear you're going to be married in Mexico.
That's right.
Oh, no family? No friends around? I hope to be part of the wedding party.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Now, where did I get the impression that you were very anti the whole thing?
I can't imagine.
You can.
Does it really matter to you?
Not to me, no. But Anne is very fond of you.
You're not a bad kid.
So what is it you call it?
Appearances, I guess.
Appearances.
Next to Anne. Now, don't get me wrong, fella. But next to Anne, you don't appear to be completely mature.
Whereas you do. Shows how appearances can be deceiving.
Billy, why didn't somebody tell me you were here? I'm so glad you got back. Did Peter tell you we're leaving tomorrow?
Yes, he told me. You look, well, wowry.
I'm switched on for the electric circus.
New hairdo?
Kenneth, Peter says any woman who can't spend $100 a week on her hair and face and fingertips isn't trying.
Is that
Do you like?
I like. I always like.
Ah, now you tell me. Well, it's too late. I misspoke. Hey. I saw Elke Schnitzel in the elevator yesterday. Her nose was running.
Don't knock my little bit of holiday cheer. Her boss is leaving, and Elke and I have the place to ourselves. But enough of me. Where are you headed in that extravaganza?
We're going to Max's Kansas City for dinner, then to Cafe La Mama, then to the electric circus, then maybe later to the graffiti. Who knows, the night before us.
How things have changed. I can't ever remember keeping Anne out past 11:30.
Well, now I love it, don't I, Peter?
She loves it.
She loves it. I went to the electric circus once. Just once.
If you think I'm going to be scared off by a little noise. Hey, Bill, wait till you see us zooming around town on the new Suzuki 5.0.
It's a bike.
A motorcycle. Peter just bought it. We got arrested last week. Oh, Billy, it was wild. We were pulled up waiting for this light at 3rd and 70th, and this black leather jacket rooms up beside us and says, "What do you get out of the tricycle, Louise?" Louise. He couldn't have been more offensive. So I said, "If you can get somebody to help you tow that junk heap over to the drive, we'll see who can get what." So we got on the drive, and he gunned after us, and he never came close to us. Unfortunately, at 96th Street, there was this cop. He came close to us.
Another scotch. Deep dish.
Yes, sir.
Hi.
Howdy, everybody.
Oh, you didn't have to come up, darling. I would have been happy to meet you downstairs.
I wanted to see Mommy before she leaves.
Hello, darling. Hello, Amy.
Mother.
Have you time for a drink?
I think maybe we'd better not. The roads are going to be crowded as hell.
Oh, dear. I always hate it when I know Trina's going to be out in holiday traffic.
At least she's going to be in a car.
Mommy, may I speak to you for a moment? Will you excuse us, please?
I want to stop and pick up some more tree ornaments on the way. There never are enough.
Okay, you may be right. I thought I nearly bought out the store, but that tree's 10 feet tall. I told them to send the biggest one they had.
If only it was snow. We could go to the midnight mass at the little church in the village. Billy, Eddie got truffles for the turkey dressing.
Truffle?
It's a 20-pounder. I told them to get the biggest one they had. Who are you spending Christmas with this year, Billy boy?
As luck would have it, I'm spending my Christmas right here in the building. I'm sharing my loneliness with another single.
I bet it's a big, long single.
I told them to get the biggest one they had. Bugging me all evening. I'm jealous.
jealous, and he can't believe that he is.
He's just that perverse. He was never jealous when we were married.
I'm very jealous of Billy. I feel very threatened by him. I know. Every time I even see you shake hands with another guy, I get a big blast of the old territorial imperative.
Oh, I can never believe it will last.
It will last as long as you want it to. I'll be here as long as you'll have me.
Why?
Because you're very neat with Kleenex.
Oh, Peter, I do wish I'd known you sooner.
I like now.
I like now, too. Do you know that for the first time in my life, I can really count on someone else? And a little child shall be...
I swear to God, Anne, if you make one more joke about my age...
Shut up. I'm older than you.
Let's skip the electric service.
Not on your life. I'm already plugged in.
It's the ghost of Christmas past.
What are you doing here? Who let you in?
Maude gave me your keys. Take care of the ferns.
Humbug. They don't need taking care of at this hour. They need their sleep.
Elkie's still busy. I knew you weren't here, so I just dropped in to look at TV. When Elkie finishes...
The TV is in the kitchen. What the devil are you doing in my bedroom?
I ducked out when I heard you coming. I didn't want to compromise you.
You've been standing behind that door with your fat ear pasted to the keyhole.
It was hardly necessary. If I were you, Annie, I wouldn't torture myself going on and on and on about all the pretty girls that Peter...
Oh, stop it, Billy. Finish your drink. And fix me one.
Thought you wanted me to go.
Fix me a drink.
I was waiting for a chance to tell you my news.
What is it?
I've had a break. I'm not... going to be at the mercy of my future son-in-law for a handout. My future ex-son-in-law, my ex-future son-in-law, you know Eddie. Anyway, what I was trying to say, I was at this party and I ran into Benjamin Wittenberg.
Who?
Benjamin Wittenberg, the big public relations guy. His clients are real biggies, like General Motors, AT&T, Rockwell Welch, New Zealand. Well, we got to talking, and I told him how I'd been feeling this last year. You know, about makeup and all that stuff. Well, he picked it up fast. "Y'all right, Barlin," he said. He said, "Barlin, I'm not knocking y'all profession, but when a man reaches 40, he wants to be in the mainstream of American life." So he set me up to see this client of his, Federico Orsini.
The Italian?
What else? Biggest film producer in Italy. Makes dirty westerns. Uses a lot of American people, and they want someone to handle the American and English press. I'd be joining their office in Rome.
Rome? You'd be entering the mainstream of American life by way of Rome?
I thought you'd be pleased for me.
You are abandoning me.
Who's getting married, you or me?
It's times like this when a person needs friends and support and affection.
You've got young Peter for affection.
It's not the same thing. You were my husband first.
Be that as it may, I don't see myself in the role of inseparable friends or the newlyweds. What's eating you, Annie? They'll have doubts about tomorrow.
No.
Then you're okay.
It's more complicated than that.
Ah.
He's so touching, Billy, the way he tries to make everything easy for me. And he's so damn young. He's so considerate and sensitive to what I want. What's right for me? Who's worrying about what's right for him? When I stand back and look at him, I can't help seeing how attractive he is. It was a really bad idea to go to the electric service.
I know what you mean. We see a whole bunch of them together.
No, he deserves something
more. And are you absolutely sure you're not in love with him?
I love his being in love with me. Could you fix me a little more scotch?
If you have any more to drink, you won't sleep.
Why don't we get smashed together? How about it?
Well, why not? It's my birthday. 38. 43.
It's the 22nd. I'm sorry, darling.
Don't be sorry. I thought you were displaying the most exquisite tact. I've stopped looking forward to these little milestones.
Thank you, Billy. Thank you for being 43. Can't tell you how grateful I am. Happy birthday, darling. It's the door.
Yes, it is. It certainly is.
Who on earth?
Elkie.
Elkie?
I didn't think she'd come down here. She doesn't approve of you.
Of me? She disapproves of me? Billy, where are you going?
If she finds me here with you, I have to get rid of her. Tell her I was gone when you got home. Act indignant.
I am indignant.
Splendid. Use the method.
Oh, you're not Elkie. I thought you were.
I was worried you couldn't sleep. I had to go to a couple of guys, but I finally found some.
Oh, that wasn't necessary.
I thought you'd be in bed.
I know. I mean, I had enough.
You look all flushed. What's the matter? You don't have a fever, do you?
No, I'm all right. I'm just surprised to see you. That's all.
I guess I made a mistake coming back unexpectedly.
No.
Sorry I barged in, Anne. I should have known better.
Peter, good night, Anne. Here, wait a minute.
All cleared away?
You might say that. Get out of here. Go pollute somebody else's air for a change. You bastard. You swine. You goddamn actor.
What did I do?
He saw your cigar and went storming out of here. Oh, Billy, I begged you for years to give
to Peter? Oh, you should have seen him. Clenched teeth, narrowed eyes. It was too ridiculous, too humiliating.
Humiliation is as humiliation does.
What does that mean?
I don't
know. Call him. No, I don't want to talk to him. I wrote him a letter. Billy took it to him this morning.
A letter? He'll die.
He's 22. He'll live.
But will you? Well, somebody's got to look after the store.
I'll be there this afternoon.
Just what you need. Call him.
Margie, give up. Give up on me.
Never, never. There's got to be somebody.
Hi, Margie.
Anybody but him.
How is everything?
Fine. Let's go have lunch. Something special. Let's go spend lots of money. You can start getting the feel of the expense account lunch.
Great. Get your coat.
And Billy, now that it's over.
What is it, kid?
I've done the right thing, haven't I?
You've done the right thing.
It was impossible, wasn't it?
Absolutely. Get your coat.
Let's go to that new... Hello, Peter.
Hello, Ann.
How are you?
I'm all right.
What are you doing here?
Our plane leaves in an hour.
Oh.
Look, Ann, I spent the whole night kicking myself, and then I went over to Billy's place and let him kick me. And well, here I am, so say goodbye while I get your thing.
But...
Behave.
You knew he was coming here.
We rode over together.
Didn't you give him my letter?
Letter? Oh, the letter. Now, what did I do with that?
Hey, Bob.
Get the rest of them.
Peter?
What is it?
There's, I forgot the toothbrush.
I'll get it.
And my blush on. Don't forget my blush on.
Blush on?
It's in the
second drawer on the left.
Why, Billy? You were so against it.
You know how many bee pictures I've made?
It's a gigantic mistake.
It's been obvious to me for some time that that's what God put us here for, to make gigantic mistakes. It's His supreme design.
Is this all?
I think so.
Thanks, Billy.
Beat it.
All right, I'll ring for the elevator. Come back for these two.
I'll get them.
you should have seen him behind stage. Like, he's 15 years old, and he would get, like, lights, like, on fire. Every little thing he would get into the middle of it. And I was just like, what are you getting into?
I don't know. A little bit of festivity here at the end of the cast party. At the end of the show, at the cast party, what I want to say. There's Barbara. Our beloved director. Sherry, the producer. Lady Ma. Mrs. Ma Gold. There's Mrs. Stanley in the corner over there. Mrs. Latham. Billy Bob. Billy Bob.
Howdy.
What's it? It's
was that the biggest?
Just about.
That was my favorite small.
I got the biggest one.
That's so funny.
He's always come back.
That's on tape, you know, for posterity's sake.
Posterity.
What the hell's that?
What? Don't
be disappointed.
What are you trying to refer to there, lady? Huh? Huh? What are you trying to refer to there, lady? Hey, get the camera out of here. Hey, go away. Go away, will you? Hey, yeah. The guy on the camera. Don't you hate these guys who walk around and fight the cameras? But people always like to watch it after. They hate it when it's happening, but they like to watch it after. Okay, that's it. Hey, Barbara, get out of the Uzo. What are you doing? Hey, hey.
Yeah, I don't know. I used to work in a cooking
restaurant. Maybe it's on a hire because
I was a vegetarian.
Bye-bye, everybody.